Are you a freelance illustrator and graphic designer looking to learn and to improve your illustration and design skills? If yes, then perfect, I got your back. Today I'll show you how to easily add grain texture to your brand and packaging vector illustration so that you'll be able to create your own organic and cool texture graphics for your client brand's identity system. Hello guys, my name is Loredana and I'm a freelance illustrator and graphic designer with a focus on playful brand identity and packaging design services for ambitious small businesses targeting female customers. Today I'll show you my two methods to add grain texture using linear, radial and freeform gradient tool in Adobe Illustrator. If you follow my work on social media, by the way, you can find me on Instagram as loredana.codal. You know that I adore using grain textures in my illustrations for packaging design, brand identity, social media assets, web assets, stationery, poster design, editorial design. And because I know how important it is to create unique illustrations, I'll show you how to create your own custom texture brush in Adobe Illustrator. So what does it mean to add texture to your graphics? Texture means adding extra highlight in any object, which enhances the detailing of a surface, helping in the understanding of the purpose of the area in the artwork. Adding texture really helps you bring a flat illustration to life. Texture gives perspective and depth to any flat color shape, creating that special organic touch. Through the last years, you saw grain textures being used literally everywhere in illustration, from corporate to small businesses' brand identities on web, social media, stationery, packaging, editorial, publishing, etc. Grain textures are versatile and they seem evergreen. Depending on the size and style, from retro to contemporary, they are perfect for a variety of brand niches. So let's dive straight into Adobe Illustrator and have some fun! We are in Adobe Illustrator into my artboard where I already created a flat color illustration brand visual asset for a tropical plant shop named Jungle Mania. As a part of the brand identity system, this tropical illustration depicting tropical plants as Monstera deliciosa, also known as the Swiss cheese plant, and Israelita or bird of paradise flowers, can be integrated into the packaging design as flower pots, wrapping paper, paper bags, stationery, social media assets, web assets. Watch until the end to see the full brand presentation. Before creating the vector illustration for this personal project, I came up with this playful and bold primary color for the brand, being inspired by the brand's niche and the tropical flora. The logo integrates an nepenthes, or tropical pitcher plant, and a twisted tropical vine. Yes, this tropical flat color illustration is modern and cool as it is, but because this brand is a plant shop, I want to add an organic touch and depth to the composition to build volume in order to emphasize the tropical brand elements. So I will shade and highlight each vector element in the composition using grain textures. Let's begin with the first method, which is perfect for linear and radial gradient. I must admit, I use the shading and highlighting method quite often because it's so easy to use and the result is priceless. Duplicate a path in front of the shape on which you want to apply the grain texture by pressing Ctrl plus C, Ctrl plus F for Windows, or Command plus C and Command plus F for Mac. Open the transparency panel. If you don't find the icon, go to Window. Pick transparency from the grid. So open the transparency panel and change the color or blending mode of your layer as you desire. This is going to be the color of your grain texture. Select Make Mask, check Clip and Invert Mask. Select the mask and paste in front the shape you duplicated in the first step by pressing Ctrl F on Windows or Command plus F on Mac. Make sure the mask is selected and open Gradient tool. Select the black and white gradient and choose which angle you desire. Open Effect texture, grain, and select stippled for grain type. Set the values for intensity and contrast as you prefer. I use usually 30-30. If you consider the shade of your grain texture as being too intense, select your mask and edit the gradient settings by replacing black with a gray in your gradient slider. For a smoother transition of your grain texture, select your mask and edit the gradient settings by setting 0% opacity for white in your gradient slider. Your grain texture is on point without stress. To successfully exit from the mask you've created inside the transparency panel, make sure you select your layer, not the mask, and close the panel. And you're done! Show your support by giving a like and pressing subscribe to my channel for more digital illustration and graphic design tips for freelancers and small business owners. Also, let me show you how I add grain texture to this illustration using Radial Gradient tool. This time I will apply the grain texture for the background, so the Radial Gradient tool was perfect. In order to fit the rectangular shape of the artboard, I'm tweaking the handles of the Radial Gradient tool so I can turn the rounded shape into an oval one and apply the gradient. For a smoother color transition, select the white point and make sure the opacity is 0%. Also, replace the black point with one of the grays. The golden rule when applying mask is that what is black is invisible and what is white is visible. But because on the transparency panel we inverted the mask, what is white now will be invisible and what is black will be visible. And this applies also when adding the grain textures. To apply grain texture is perfect in combination with Freeform Gradient tool. The Freeform Gradient allows you to create more complex and interesting shadings and highlightings to your illustration project. Duplicate and pass in front the shape on which you want to apply the grain texture by pressing Ctrl plus C and Ctrl plus F on Windows and Command plus C, Command plus F on Mac. Open the transparency panel. Select the mask and pass in front the shape you duplicated in the first step by pressing Ctrl F on Windows or Command plus F on Mac and change the color and the blending mode as you desire. This is going to be the color of your grain texture. Make sure the mask is selected and open Gradient tool. Ensure draw points are selected and place your color points on the shape as you desire by choosing black and white. If you consider the shade of your grain texture as being too intense, select your mask and edit the gradient settings by replacing black with a gray. For a smoother color transition, unify the black and the white points. Open Effect, pick Texture and select Grain. Select Stippled for Grain Type. Set the values for intensity and contrast as you prefer. To successfully exit from the mask you've created inside the transparency panel, make sure you select the layer and close the panel. And you're done! As a bonus illustration tip, I will show you how to create your own custom texture brush in Adobe Illustrator. So, what you have to do for this one? Draw on your artboard tiny black shapes as circles, squares, whatever, squiggles of different sizes. This will form the texture brush. Select your shapes, go to brushes and pick add new brush. Select scatter brush, leaving the settings as they are and press OK. Now your brush is saved and you may delete the created shapes. Go on the layer of the shape on which you want to apply the grain texture and select Draw Inside mode. Select your brush, only making sure the stroke is selected, and set the color you wish to apply. Draw it inside the shape, where you want your texture to show. Your brush needs some adjustment, so double tap on it on the brush panel to open scatter brush options. Set size, spacing, and rotation as you wish. Set colorization method to hue shift and press OK. Select apply to strokes on the pop-up which appears on your screen. Now the green texture you applied with your custom scatter brush has the color you have previously chosen. You are almost done. If you're not completely satisfied with your previous settings, simply edit your strokes, their position inside the shape or their weight in appearance. And you're done! Now you can easily use your custom texture brush on shapes by applying it and tweaking it as needed. Save your brush so you'll be able to use it also on future illustration projects. Are you ready to finally meet the brand new identity and packaging design of Jungle Mania, the coolest tropical plant shop in town? But first, I want to thank you for watching my video, and I hope my free methods to add green texture in Adobe Illustrator will help you to improve your illustration skills and workflow. Show your support by giving a like and pressing subscribe to my channel for more digital illustration and graphic design tips for freelancers and small business owners. Ladies and gentlemen, I present you Jungle Mania.